we took a trip to Cornell to meet with Dr. David Pimentel, an entomologist. Pimentel's expertise is actually studying bugs, but he receives independent funding to write anti-ethanol papers. With his research partner, Ted Patzik, Pimentel says it takes more energy to produce a gallon of ethanol than the energy you get out of it.
With corn ethanol, it takes 1.5 gallons of fossil energy to produce 1 gallon of ethanol.
I asked him what he factored into his equations.
A lot of them do not include the machinery. They do not include energy for irrigation, energy for producing the hybrid corn. You have to transport, of course, the corn to the processing plant. Oh, another thing they leave out is the labor. Anyway, there's about 40 or 50 inputs.
Researchers at UC Berkeley compared Pimentel and Patzik's widely quoted 2005 anti-ethanol paper with five others. They found critical statistics in Pimentel's paper were decades old. He used outdated and inefficient data. In some cases, he used different data than those in the sources he cited, with no explanation for the discrepancy.
All of the papers not written by Pimentel and Patzik found a net energy increase for corn ethanol. The Berkeley researchers concluded that ethanol has a positive energy balance, and they're not